Hello everyone, my name is John Melisandre and today I'm gonna teach you on how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. It is a snowy Christmas Eve with the house and the snowman. And please don't forget to subscribe, you have subscribed it, and hit that bell button if you want to receive some future notification of my new videos and tutorials. Okay everyone, you can see all the materials here in the screen. You can see there the 5 limited colors, the brushes I'm gonna use, and also all the other things that we're gonna need to paint the tutorial. Okay, so today I'm gonna paint like Christmas Eve. Okay, so I'm gonna do a little sketching first before we're gonna start. I have here the number 2 flat brush with the raw umber and then the white. I'm mixing white so that it will be easier for me to cover it with other paints, especially the light colors. Yeah, I'm gonna put the house here. It will be a beautiful house. Just a small beautiful house. So I'm gonna put a snowman here. There. Well, maybe something like this has. Just a simple, beautiful house, everyone. On the snow, something like this. Okay. And here, I will put the snowman. He's wearing a black hat. This was just a very basic tutorial for beginners. I don't want to also to put everything hard tutorials or something like advanced tutorials. I want also to put some beginner tutorials. Some trees here, pine trees, and then I'm gonna make it as I will also make this an afternoon with some moon there. Okay, there. So I think I'm gonna start now. I'm done with the sketching. It should be first I'll start off, and then I'm going to use this blue and the red. So of course I'm gonna make it dark. I'm gonna put a little light, just a little light here. It's okay everyone, if we could cover some parts of the sky. Yeah, there's no chicken or rooster in my neighbor, always shouting. Yeah, and it's fun to hear them. Okay, I have here some more blue and the raw umber and in white. I want to make it this bottom a little lighter. But I still want to see dark sky there. So I'm gonna put more bluish color or purple.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I will put the moon here, this part. But of course, I'm gonna put it later on. Yeah, okay. So I'm just trying to see if it's all on focus or not. Okay, I think that's perfect. I'll try to put some dark mountains here with some dark purples, okay? It's okay if you cover some parts of your yeah, and then I'm gonna put a little lighter because it's a snow, everyone. It might be a little more foggy. Yeah, the chickens are really nice here. And then I'm gonna make the background a little lighter, but not so much. Just make it lighter like this. It's okay if you cover some parts, some of the stone one, it will be fine. We're just gonna put some colors later on. I'll just have to cover everything here with the underpainting. Yeah, I like everything first to cover with these colors because it will be easy for me to put the highlights later on, and all I have to do is just put all the highlights. Thank you. there. I like it's very plain now, and I like the blending is very soft. Okay, I will be using another brush. This is the number 8 nylon top brush. I hope I can finish it faster and easy. Yeah, I like it. I'll be using this raw umber with a little blue. Yeah. Just a little curve here, yeah. So I'll try to blend on the bottom here. Just to make it clean. Yeah. And then I'll try to make it a little purple for the roof here. Looks brownish, but it's okay, everyone. We just have to retouch that later on. Yeah, I have another house, and then yeah, I think this one is dry. I'm gonna proceed it here. I'm gonna put the moon here. I think I'm gonna put the moon here. It's very good. Yeah. I have here the white, the plain white. Yeah, I'll put it here. There, another moon, and then I'll start adding some clouds there on top. Yeah, just use the plain white. Of course the light is coming from the moon, so I'm gonna put the light everything here. I'm not sure really, sometimes I've never been in the snow countries before, so I'm not sure if there are really plenty of clouds or maybe no cloud at all during the winter. So yeah, maybe if there's no clouds, this will become soil. Okay, I'll just blend it here in the pot. Thank you. Okay. You can blend it using your fingers because it's still wet. It's good to blend. There. Yeah, I think this will be good. Yeah, that looks good. Okay, and then I'm gonna put the snow on the mountain. And I'll be using the same color, wood white. Yeah, I just want to exaggerate things here. You just have to blend a little. It's just a dry brush, everyone. I'm using a dry brush. Okay. And then I'm gonna use some white. I'm gonna put some little far mountains here. Yeah. Then you can try to blend it. Okay, maybe using some more water. Or your fingers. Okay. Yeah. Okay, I think that looks like a good mountains. Yeah. And then I'm going to put some more. I think I'm gonna start putting some pine trees. So I'll be using this one first, the bristle flat brush. Again, I'm gonna use this blue and the red. And a little white will be purple, everyone. Yeah, here. Yeah, and then I'm gonna use this raw umber and the blue. I want it dark, really dark. So I'm gonna put it here. It's too much greenish. I'm gonna put red and blue. There. And then you can put some leaves on these pine trees. There. Okay. And then I think I'm gonna put also some pine trees or other trees in the back of the house. Yeah, maybe just other kind of trees here. But this is just the underpainting, everyone. I'm gonna make it white later on. So of course it's snowing, everyone, and they should have no leaves there except for the pine trees. That looks good. Yeah, just had to let it dry first. Okay, and then I'm going to try to put something more here. I'm gonna make this use this white. I'm gonna lighten this part here because let us see that this has been hit by the sunlight something. I'm mixing a little lighter color, lighter purple. Okay, in the back of this house there is some lake or something, frozen lake. Yeah. There. And this one here, it will be not so light. Okay. And then I will put some, but here it will be a pathway, so it will be a little lighter. But I'm gonna make it a little not so, it will be much more like purple or something like a reddish purple. This will be like a frozen pathway here. Thank you. just try to blend it here, something like this. There. Yeah, that looks good. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to add more light details. I think I will try to put details here in the house, but I will be using a smaller brush. And here I have some amber again and some red and blue. Okay, and I'll be using the blue color to sketch for the snowman. So here, I'm gonna put the snowman here. And then I will be using a lighter color. I'll try to add some details in this moment. Okay, here I have some blue and yellow to make some greens. I'll try to create a ribbon here. And then of course the highlights from the sun, I'm going to also to put. Later I'm gonna put the hat. And then using this purple, blue, and red. I also need to put some shadow like that. Okay, and then I'll start to put some more highlights. I'm gonna use the white and in here. This will be light from the sun, everyone, from there. And then here also. and then here. Okay, and of course, we're gonna start putting some highlights on the pine trees. So using this number 8 flat brush. Okay, just put all the highlights to the left side. Okay. Yeah. Okay, and also maybe this background here, I'm gonna make it more like pine trees. So probably let me see, I get some okay, just make it those trees pointed, something like this. Yeah, I'm going to mix for a little lighter, and then I'm gonna put also some snow here on the leaves. But I think the background color is still wet, so it will be hard for us to put some maybe we just have to let it dry more. Okay. Yeah, but so far it looks good. Everything looks good. Yeah. Yeah, and also I think I need to start retouching the house. I'm using a smaller brush. I think I'm gonna I'm gonna put first some chimney here. And of course this color here, which is a little bluish, And then on the top, it should be very white. There. That looks good. And then using the light orange, yellow and white, I'm gonna put a window here. There. That means there's light inside this window. And of course the door here. And then another window. There. Yeah, so far I love this one. And of course we need to put some, using the same color, you need to put some highlights from these windows. Yeah, here. There, and also here. Now use the dry brush, everyone. The dry brush, so that it will, you can just blend it like that. Okay. There. So you have now some lights coming from the house. Yeah. Looks good. Yeah. And then I'll try to retouch everything, especially from this house. I'll be using a liner brush. I'll be using some light raw umber. there. You can put like a design on the it looks like a rock, everyone. Just put plenty of designs there. I just use some raw umber. Just make the window straight. Okay. Yeah, I'll just make the window a little partially open. I mean the door. Yeah, I'll make it, I'll try to make it red. Like a light brown. And then I'm gonna use this little dark blue or blue with the raw umber. Also lines here on the windows. Just three lines on one. Okay. Yeah, that looks good. I'm going to try to retouch the house. Let's add some more highlights, especially here. I'll put some details, everyone, some tiny details here. Okay. And then here, I'm gonna make it light. Yeah. I just have to retouch everyone, retouch everything here. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, I think that house looks cute. Okay, now I'm going to put some highlights on these trees. So we'll be using this one. Some snows on the. I'm gonna put some snows on the because on the leaves. There, and of course also these pine trees. And also here. I just want to create a good contrast here, everyone. That's why I'm using very light color, white. And then I'm going to use natural white. Sorry everyone if some noise in my background. Also here. Okay. I think that looks really pretty easy for us and for everyone. A little light here. There. And then I'm gonna put a little dark. Using the purple. Just here. So you can see clearly the pathway. There. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm gonna put more dark on the house. Blue and the red. And the raw umber. Okay, and also here, I'll try to put a little designs. On the roof. There. Maybe here. Okay. And then I will try to add some details on this snowman room. I'll be using some more white. Yeah, and then I'll try to make it a little lighter, and this part I'll just make it light, that there's some diffuse light coming from this part here. I'm using the dry brush. Yeah. And then I'm gonna put a hat on this snowman. I'll try to put the black hat. Or something like near to the purple. Okay, and then a little shades. Just to make it look more round. And then let's try to put some eyes and nose. And then some brown color for the hands. It will be like a twig. So. I'm gonna make the nose red. And then his ribbon tie or something on the neck. I'm gonna make it green. Yeah. Okay, and then a little highlights from the hat. There. Okay, I think that's really pretty good. So far, I really love the result of this one. It's just very easy, everyone. I recommend this tutorial for the beginners because it doesn't look so hard for them. And I love the entire look of this tutorial. It looks just very simple. It's not even look. Realistic. Yeah, but I think I'm gonna need to put some falling snow there. I like it. I like to see it there. Even if there's a sun, there's falling snow. But I still love it. So I want to put some trees here. Yeah, I'll just try to retouch and I think I am done. Just a few more retouch, putting some more depths, something. Yeah, here, especially here. Just want to put some darks here. Yeah, it looks like a yeah, I think also here. Some few more darks. Looks like a shadow. Okay, and I think yeah, I really want to put some falling snow there and it will be it, finish. Okay. Okay, so I'll just use this liner brush. And then make it wet and put some white. And then just falling snow. Do not make it too white or too big. There, yeah. piece of toy doesn't look realistic, but I love the entire result. Okay, yeah, everyone. Okay, I think I am done, everyone. And I think I am pretty much pleased with my tutorial. It's not so hard. I think it will be just for the beginners. Yeah, and yeah. And I say thank you and Merry Christmas, everyone. And I think I'm very good with this one. It's just, I really recommend this for beginners. This tutorial is really for beginners, and it's just very easy and it's just 1 hour.
Okay, everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like and some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.